Good morning children. In the previous video I explained about equal sacrifice. If the old partners equally sacrifice their share of profit towards new partner, how to calculate new profit sharing ratio I explained. Okay, today in this video we'll see the remaining topics. The second topic is unequal sacrifice. It means if the old partners unequally sacrifice their share of profit towards new partner, how to calculate new profit sharing ratio. Look at the problem. A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admit C for the 1/5 share of profits, which he acquires 3/20 from A and 1/20 from B. So calculate new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio. Here A is sacrificing 3/20 and B is sacrificing 1/20. It means separate ratio they have sacrificed. So this type of problems are very easy to work out. It means directly we can deduct their sacrificing share from their old share. That's all. Look at the answer. Calculation of new profit sharing ratio A, B, C. Old ratio 3/5 and 2/5. Next is sacrificing share for A 3/20 and B 1/20. We can apply directly into the formula. New profit sharing ratio equal to old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. For A, 3/5 is old share and sacrificing share is 3/20. And for B, 2/5 is old share and 1/20 sacrificing share. And C, to make it as equivalent fraction, we can multiply into 4/4. Okay. For A, 3/5 minus 3/20 will be 12 minus 3/20. For B, 2/5 minus 1/20, 8 minus 1/20. For C, it is 4/20. So to make it as equivalent fraction, we can multiply into 4/4 for A and B also. So the new profit sharing ratio will be 9:7:4. Next, their sacrificing ratio we have to calculate. So directly we can write as it is, because sacrificing share itself particularly given, so we can write. So for A and B, 3/20 and 1/20, so it is 3:1. Okay. Next, third one, entire sacrifice by only one partner. It means only one partner will sacrifice to new partner. So in such a case, how to do the problem? Let's see. A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio 5:2. That means C for 1/7 share, which he acquires entirely from A. So calculate new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio. Here A alone is sacrificing his share to C, so we have to deduct from only A. Okay, now look at the answer. Calculation of new profit sharing ratio for A, B and C. Old ratio 5/7 and 2/7 for A and B, and sacrificing share equal to only for A 1/7. So directly we can apply into the formula. So new profit sharing ratio equal to old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Here A alone is sacrificing, so from A alone we have to deduct. So his old share is 5/7 and sacrificing share is 1/7. B as it is we can write, and C you can write as it is. Next step, 5/7 minus 1/7 equal to 4/7, and 2/7 you can write as it is because denominators are equal already. For C also 1/7. So their new profit sharing ratio will be 4:2:1. And sacrificing ratio, here A alone in sacrificing, so we can write as it is sacrificing share for A 1/7. Okay. Fourth one, when sacrifice unknown. This type of adjustment is very important and it will come in 8-mark question as a adjustment. Okay. When sacrifice unknown, it means old partner's sacrifice will not be given in the question. So in such a case, how to find out new profit sharing ratio? Let's see. A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio 5:2. They admit C for 1/5 share as a new partner. Calculate new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio. Look at the answer. Calculation of new profit sharing ratio. Here the way is different to calculate new profit sharing ratio. Okay, let the profit be 1, new partner share is 1/5 and their old partner's remaining share is 1 minus 1/5 equal to 4/5. It means 4/5 only the remaining share, this 1/5 share only they have sacrificed. Okay, so A, B and C, old ratio equal to 5/7 and 2/7. Next, old partner's remaining share we have to multiply into their old share for getting new profit sharing ratio. So 5/7 into 4/5 for A, for B 2/7 into 4/5, and for C 1/5. Now we have to multiply. So 5 by 7 into 4 by 5, if you multiply, we will get 20 by 35. Next, 2 by 7 into 4 by 5, if you multiply, we will get 8 by 35. And to make it as equivalent to denominator, we can multiply into 7 by 7 for C. So 1 by 5 into 7 by 7, we have to multiply. So we will get 20:8:7 as new profit sharing ratio. Next, sacrificing ratio we have to calculate. So old ratio minus new ratio is the formula to calculate sacrificing ratio. For A and B, old ratio 5:7:2. Next, new ratio equal to 20:35 and 8:35. So we have to deduct old ratio minus new ratio. So sacrificing ratio equal to, for A, old share is 5:7 and new share is 20:35. For B, old share is 2:7 and new share is 8:35. So to make it as equivalent fraction of old ratio, we can multiply into 5:5. Next, for A, 25 minus 20 by 35 equal to 5. For B, 10 minus 8 by 35 equal to 2. So their sacrificing ratio will be 5:2. Next, fifth topic is surrender value. Here, old partners will surrender their share of profit towards a new partner. So how to calculate new profit sharing ratio under this case? Okay, let's see. Radha and Rukmani are partners in a firm sharing profits in 3:2 ratio. They admitted Gopi has a new partner. Radha surrendered 1/3 of her share and Rukmani surrendered 1/4 of her share towards Gopi. So how to calculate new profit sharing ratio? Look at the answer. Radha's old ratio 3:5 and Rukmani's old ratio 2:5. Next, surrender value for both of them 1/3 and 1/4. So to get sacrificing share, we have to multiply both. So 3:5 into 1/3, 2:5 into 1/4. So their sacrificing share will be 3:15 and 2:20. Next, Gopi's new share we have to calculate. We have to add the old partner sacrificing share to Gopi. So it will be 3:15 plus 2:20. So to make it as equivalent to fraction of denominators, we can multiply into 4:4. So he will get 12:60 plus 6:60 equal to 18:60 as a new share. Next, for old partners new ratio, we have to find out their old ratio. For Radha 3:5, Rukmani 2:5, then sacrificing share 3:15 for Radha and Rukmani 2:20. Now we have to deduct old ratio minus sacrificing ratio to get new ratio. Look at the answer. New profit sharing ratio equal to 3:5 minus 3:15, then 2:5 minus 2:20, and Gopi we have to write as it is. And to make it as a equivalent fraction, for Radha we can multiply into 3:3 into their old share, and for Rukmini 4:4 into their old share. So it will be 9 minus 3, 8 minus 2, and 8:60. So here for Radha and Rukmini, again denominators are different, so we can take LCM to make equivalent fraction. So we can multiply 4:4 for Radha and Rukmini 3:3. So 6:15 into 4:4 and 6:20 into 3:3 and 18:60. Next, we can multiply to get new profit sharing ratio. For Radha 24:60, for Rukmini 18:60, and Gopi 18:60. Now the denominators are equal, so their new profit sharing ratio will be 24:18:18, otherwise 4:3:3. So in such a way we have to calculate new profit sharing ratio. Okay, next, sacrificing ratio. For Radha and Rukmani, they have sacrificed 3:15 and 2:20. Already it is given. So simply we have to make it as an equivalent fraction. So we can multiply for Radha 4:4 and for Rukmini 3:3. So Radha will get 12:60 and Rukmini will get 6:60. So their sacrificing ratio will be 12:6 or 2:1. Okay children, in such a way we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio in all the cases. In the next class we'll see how to value goodwill and what is accounting treatment of goodwill. Thank you.